In this video, I'm going to be sharing with you one of my favorite passing concepts in Madden 21. What's up, guys? My name is Cody, and I want to thank you for taking the time out of your day to watch this video. If it's your first time visiting my channel is all about helping people become the best Madden player that they can possibly become. And so if you are sitting there looking to get better at this game, I want to encourage you to hit the subscribe button at the bottom right-hand corner of your screen. It's completely free to subscribe, and it just allows you to be able to stay up to date with the latest tips and strategies here on the YouTube channel. All right, guys, so what we're going to be talking about today is the gun spread. And really specifically what I want to hit on within the gun spread is a play that you can really use in any situation, right? In any situation, you could go to something like this play, this concept, and you're going to have some success. Now, really quick, before we dive too far into this video, I do want to let you know that I actually have a full ebook out on the Arizona Cardinals gun spread formation. So it covers the gun spread, the spread Y slot, also covers some of the cluster and some of the trips and different things like that from the formation. So it's basically my suggested way for you to be able to run the gun spread in Madden 21. It's kind of an air raid style approach to Madden 21 based off of the air raid offense. And so if you want to get that ebook, I'm going to leave a link to that in the description of this video. But it also, it's basically my full spread offense. It also comes with my 4-6 defense. So you get both my offense and my defense with that. So again, I'm going to leave that in the description for you if you want to check that out. Now, the play that we're going to be talking about in today's video is we're going to spend a little bit of time talking about the play Y corner and why it is so effective at this point in the season. So part of the reason why this route is really, really powerful is because it is a smart routable route. What I mean by that is I can smart route it. As you can see, it's going to be turning into this little really sharp corner route. Now, what I like to do with this is I like to motion my tight end to the right. As you can see right here, it's going to put him in a very interesting little position. He's going to kind of be a little bit, again, he's just going to be a little bit more on the numbers on the hash. You don't have to do that if you don't want to. You can leave him spread. But really, from that point, all I'm going to do is essentially turn this into a 3x1. So I might want to run the running back on a streak, as you can see right here. And then on the left side, maybe what I would do is something like that, right? This could be a real combination that I would utilize. Another thing that you could do if you wanted to is you can motion this receiver to the right. And then as you can see, now you've got some other things that you've got to kind of think about. So for example, you could do something like this. And now this is kind of what you could do, this kind of route combination right here. There's multiple. The cool part about the spread is it's very much so like where there's a lot of different opportunities. But you'll see if you do a route combination just like this right here, this X receiver is going to do a really good job at getting open on the outside, especially if you have like a tight end that has pretty good route running. This is another thing that you can really use. I don't necessarily like to do something like this, like a traditional kind of flood. I mean, you can, as you can see, the spacing's not as bad as it kind of looks on the screen. The circle receiver does get down the field a lot faster because he's just simply a lot faster, right? That's about a scantling with 93 speed. Whereas in mutt, you know, you might have a little bit of issue because your tight ends are going to be, most of the time your tight ends are going to be in positions where, you know, where they're going to be a little bit faster. But I will tell you something about this double slant combination, especially with the fact that we have transitioned, at least at this point in the season, where people are not running as much man coverage. And if they are running man coverage, it's not as effective because they don't have one step ahead. These slants are pretty good. Like, one of the slants will always get open. I honestly have actually been leaving the slants a lot from spread. Another thing that you could do if you wanted to is you could do something like this, where you basically have this is the cool part about spread is again, what you want to leverage is the spacing of the field, the fact that you have so much space. So you see here, I could do like a slant flat combination on the left side, and as you can see, there's just so much space that I have now opened up. That's kind of the beauty of this offense. Now, the other thing that I want to hit on really quickly about the tight end in this situation is that tight end will almost never get bumped, because most people understand that if I am running a formation like this, then I could audible down into, you know, something like a single back bunch. You know, I'm in that personnel grouping, so I could audible to anything really. So because of that, he typically, and again, it is route running based, or if he has an ability, he typically does a decent job. You'll see here that if I flip the play, this now allows the opportunity for a receiver to run that. So I could put Devontae Adams in that position and now have something, you know, even just really, really good, as you can see on the sideline. It just gets open every time. So that's kind of the basics of the routes. There's a lot of freestyling that you can do. I'm not going to say that you have to run it this way or that way. I'm just going to simply say that the route combination is very, very effective, okay? And so what I want to talk about now is I want to just simply talk about, you know, kind of, again, if it's zone coverage, if you read zone coverage, then what I would recommend is running a curl flat concept. I would always have a curl flat concept. This is going to be a very good little ability to be able to space the field. You know, so you could do something like this right here. You have a flood to the right. You also have a curl flat check down to the left. And if they're in that cover three Mabel, because you're running a spread offense, okay, the cover three Mabel is not as good against spread because of the spacing that spread has, a spacing advantage. So what you'll see here is, you know, this is kind of what a traditional defense would look like, something like this right here, where I've got two flats that are shaded at 25 yards, okay? But because they're inside of that receiver will oftentimes have a big-time advantage. So you'll see right here that there's no way for that flat to get out there because, it's the spacing of the formation, okay, the spreadness of it, the 53-3. We're going to use the whole field. That's kind of the theory behind the air raid. And so, you know, what I want to hit on here just briefly is that if you leverage those corner routes to the wide side of the field, you're going to find that you're going to have a ton of success with that. Now, something that I didn't hit on too much, and I want to hit on just briefly here, and we're going to use just the kind of standard cover three to do this. But if you watch this running back route, if I were to put the running back on a streak, and then again, just on the backside, you know, do something like maybe this, you know, maybe a slant, maybe not, you know, but something like this. But I use my running back as my vertical pull route. It's actually going to work out pretty well for me because you see that running back, it is something that they have to man up. Zone coverage is not going to stop a running back streak, so especially out of spread. So you could do something just like this right here. You know, the very, very simple little route combination out of this, but due to the spread and the spacing of the formation, you're going to find yourself having a lot of success, right? You see that the corner route doesn't get pulled as much. If they are in like a deep third or something, they're going to have success with that, but you're going to have a decent chance. So that leaves me to the next thing here, which is a cover two style defense. So if I run this combination, something like this right here, you might even want to run your running back on an option route. You know, you can, again, it's very, very customizable, but this fade to the right side against a cover two, again, it's a fade on a wide side of the field. And so because of that, if you run that circle receiver on a fade, even if they're in like the kind of Tampa twos where they'll jam and they'll release it, it's going to get very open. As you can see, I just passed it to the right. It's wide open. The one thing that's not going to be open against a cover two style defense is if they have that corner route's not going to have a chance against that. But one last thing I did want to hit on with this play concept is what if they have, you know, what if they do something like a cover three, but they use that safety because he has outside leverage. You see that he's able to get out there. That's where, again, you're going to have to innovate a little bit. You're going to have to throw that. You're going to have to throw that route a little bit shallower. So you might throw that on the cut. The beauty of the spread, again, is that it's going to expose what the defense is doing pretty quickly. I mean, you're going to know really, really quickly. So you see, like right there, and I can just lowball it. See, a little quick pop pass. If I need it, if they're in a situation where they're doing something like that. The other thing that's going to be wide open, you know, again, in those situations, if they're running something like that, the thing that you're going to have going for you is you are really clearing out a lot of space. The slant will work. I mean, it's just something that's going to get open. So, anyways, that's a little bit about the gun spread. That's just one play of several plays. If you want to learn my entire offensive system for the air raid or the spread offense, I'm going to leave a link to that in the description of this video. I want to thank you for taking the time to watch this video. And if you have any questions, feel free to text me. My cell phone number is 208-218-6900. Thanks for your time. Hope you enjoyed the video, and we will talk to you guys in a bit.